as we explore fundamental reality using AI as a means to explore spiritual intelligence. I want to share today's prompt. Please explore and help me create an argument that Vedic mathematics is the basis of Vedic astrology, which in turn is an expression of karma. And karma is not deterministic but probabilistic. I would like to explore this in the light of the wave function in quantum mechanics. So here's the answer. Vedic mathematics is a system of mathematics that originated in ancient India and is based on the Vedas, the sacred texts of Eastern wisdom traditions and Hinduism. It is known for its unique techniques and shortcuts for performing mathematical calculations. Vedic astrology, on the other hand, is a traditional system of astrology that is also rooted in the Vedas. It uses planetary positions and their correlations with human life events to make predictions and interpretations about various aspects of a person's life. One of the fundamental concepts in Vedic astrology is the notion of karma. Karma refers to the law of cause and effect, where one's actions in the past influence their present and future experiences. In this context, karma is often viewed as a complex web of interconnected actions and consequences. While Vedic astrology considers karma in its interpretations, it is important to note that karma itself is not deterministic but probabilistic. This means that the actions and choices in the past may influence the likelihood of certain events or outcomes, but they do not guarantee them with absolute certainty. The probabilistic nature of karma aligns with the principles of quantum mechanics, where probabilities play a fundamental role in describing the behavior of particles and events at the quantum level. In quantum mechanics, the concept of wave functions and probability distributions provides a framework for understanding the inherent uncertainty and unpredictability in the universe. Similarly, in the context of karma, the probabilistic nature implies that while certain actions and choices may increase the likelihood of specific outcomes, there is always an element of uncertainty and free will involved. People have the ability to make choices and decisions that can shape their future, even though the influence of past actions may be present. It is important to recognize that Vedic astrology, like any form of astrology, is a belief system and should be approached with a critical mindset. I should add to that that science is also a belief system based on the assumption that everything starts with matter, when in fact matter is a perceptual activity in consciousness. And we've discussed that many times. So in that sense, even science is a belief system. So while it may provide insights and guidance for some individuals, it is not considered as scientific or deterministic method for predicting future events. I would say, nor is quantum physics a science for total determinism. In any way, in summary, Vedic mathematics and Vedic astrology are interconnected disciplines rooted in ancient Indian traditions. While Vedic astrology considers the concept of karma, it is important to understand that karma itself is probabilistic. Then I said, what is Vedic mathematics based on? Vedic mathematics is based on the Vedas, the sacred texts of Hinduism. The Vedas are ancient Indian scriptures that contain a vast array of knowledge, including mathematical principles and techniques. Vedic mathematics is believed to have been developed by ancient sages or rishis who discovered and compiled these mathematical concepts within the Vedas. The techniques and methods of Vedic mathematics are found in various sections of the Vedas, such as the Atharva Veda and the Shulba Sutras. These texts contain mathematical formulas, algorithms and shortcuts that enable faster and more efficient calculations. Vedic mathematics emphasizes the use of sutras, which are concise mathematical aphorisms or principles. These sutras provide general methods and rules that can be applied to solve a wide range of mathematical problems. The simplicity and flexibility of the sutras make Vedic mathematics a unique and powerful system for performing mathematical calculations. Some of the key principles in Vedic mathematics include the concept of digit sums, where the sum of the digits of a number can reveal certain properties or relationships, and the use of complementary numbers to simplify calculations. Vedic mathematics also introduces techniques for multiplication, division, squaring, square roots, and other mathematical operations. The beauty of Vedic mathematics lies in its simplicity and its ability to provide alternative approaches to traditional methods. It offers a holistic and intuitive way of understanding and applying mathematical concepts. And then there are many principles that are very technical. Sanskrit words, ekadhikena, purvena, nikhilam sutra, urdhva, anurupena sutra, paravatya sutra, shunyam sama sutra, etc., etc., and the numerous examples. So now we see the connection between the wave function at a very elementary level of measurement, and then we can see it as applied holistically as a window to both the understanding that memory and karma and past experience influence present choices but do not categorically determine them, and opens the window. Therefore, both Vedic mathematics and quantum mechanics open the window to free will. Here's a nice visual of, you know, one of the yantras, you might say, that exemplifies how Vedic mathematics could be used. So I hope you find this useful, the connection between karma, Vedic mathematics, Vedic astrology, and quantum mechanics.